Russia's defense ministry says it has launched joint military drills in neighboring Belarus. And that, of course, adds to the tensions. It's putting pressure on oil prices. Brent is now more than $90 a barrel. It's up 50% in the last year. And JP Morgan says it'll go to 120 if Russia-Ukraine crisis escalates into fighting. Who knows where it'll go in that eventuality. France is making a big bet on nuclear energy to fight climate change. President Macron announced his country would build six new nuclear reactors as he visited a GE factory to announce the deal. France's state-owned company, electric company, is buying part of GE's nuclear steam turbine business. Vattenfall is the state-owned power company in Sweden. About a third of its electricity comes from nuclear plants. Vattenfall delivers electricity to nearly 7 million customers across six European countries. Anna Borg is the chief executive. She joins me now. Anna, it is good to see you. I'm grateful you've joined us tonight. Look, wherever I look, I hear higher fuel prices. I understand this is what's happening in the market, and I understand this is, there's not a lot that CEOs can do about it, but it is going to take its toll, especially in those markets where, or in those countries where there has been deregulation of energy provision, isn't it?
Well, I would say that the market situation for the energy market in entire Europe has been quite unusual this winter due to the high fuel prices, as you indicate, but also because the weather has been quite cold. In Europe, however, there is a transformation going on with the clear aim to phase out the fossil fuels like gas and oil and coal and move into a fossil-free energy system. And that transformation is in the making. In Vattenfall, which is a European country originating from Sweden, we decided a few years ago to set out on a journey which we call Enable a Fossil-Free Living Within One Generation. And you can see all around Europe that the competitive situation is shifting away from fossil fuels and into renewables and into more nuclear power.
And yet, you know, of course, I'm old enough to remember all the protests against nuclear power, which was seen to be dangerous. And that. Now, if not exactly the answer, it's certainly a major part of the equation and formula, as we saw today in France.
Well, I think that if it's going to be possible to both mitigate the climate change and also transfer industry and way of living into these new fossil-free environment, it's going to be necessary to explore all of the fossil-free technologies, including, for example, the new small modular nuclear reactors. And it is possible, I think, because you can see that there's a lot of innovation going on around the fossil-free technologies, and you can also clearly see that the customer demand is shifting. So I would argue that this is actually a matter of being competitive in the new business environment in the future. So the sort of transformation needs to happen sooner rather than later, right, for many reasons.
The disparity between sustainable goals, the provision of electricity, the emissions trading systems that are in place, what is it you now want to see?
Well, I think that the emission trading system is extremely important because that puts a price on the emissions, and that also changes the relative competitiveness between technologies. Right. But it also sparks a lot of innovation around fossil-free technologies. And today, I think we can see that companies and customers are actually moving much faster than nations or global initiatives. So I think that, again, this is a business strategy for us. It's not the sustainability strategy first and foremost. It's a business strategy and it is sustainable, but we can clearly see that through this transformation, we are actually getting increasingly competitive.
We looked at the breakdown of your provision of electricity, and you still get, there is still a 20-odd percent from fossil. At the end of the day, do you see much higher prices coming, whether from supply issues, whether from Ukraine, worries about geopoliticals? If that gets worse, how much worse do you think it gets?
Well, first of all, the situation looks a bit different in different countries, so I think that impact will also be different in that sense. But it is true that fossil fuels, and especially natural gas, will be an important transition fuel for quite some time. Whether the prices will be higher or not, I'm not sure, but they will definitely be more volatile. So they will be higher at certain times and lower at other times. And yes, there is, of course, an import into Europe from Russia and other countries when it comes to gas. But we also see an increased import now, especially of LNG, liquid natural gas, from the US. So it depends a bit on the many factors going forward.
Anna Borg, it's good to have you with us this evening from Stockholm. I'm grateful that you joined us. Thank you, ma'am.